In this video, we are going to see the simple microscope. What is simple microscope? The palm reader using a convex lens to see the palm and the lines in the palm. That is the simple microscope. Even we are using some reading lens to enlarge the letter and see. That is the simple microscope. In the sixth question of a convex lens, we saw that as usual 2 centimeters center, one is optic center, next one is f1 to f1, and this side f2 to f2, and draw the lens at the center. Then keep the object in front of the, in between the optic center and focal point. Then what is the two rules? First ray is parallel and the next ray is passing through the center. The ray which is parallel to the principal axis, this is the principal axis. The principal axis is the line which is passing through the optic center and the focal point and center of curvature, isn't it? The parallel ray after refraction will pass through the focus. Will pass through the focus. Before the focal point, the object is placed. So the image will be formed on the same side by extending the line. By extending the these two lines, these two lines will meet at a point. You'll be getting an enlarged image, enlarged erect image. This is the simple microscope, simple convex lens. Short focal length of your convex lens makes your image magnified. So this is your simple microscope ray diagram. Have you understood? Simple microscope as a convex lens of short focal length, it is held near the eye to get a enlarged small object. Okay, if you keep the object in front of the focus, that is in between the optic center and focal point, you'll get an enlarged image on the same side. This image is called as erect, visual and enlarged image. Uses of simple microscope. It is used by the watch repairers and jewelers to read small letters clearly, to observe parts of a flowers, insects, etc., to observe fingerprints in the field of forensic science. This is the simple microscope ray diagram. And compound microscope. Compound means more than one. Combining two lenses, it will have an small lens just marked 2 centimeter as usual. In this, I'm going to write F1, 2F1. Instead of writing F1 and 2F1, I'll be writing FO and 2FO. O means objective. At the center, I'm going to draw a small lens. And I'm going to keep an object in between FO and 2FO. As usual, the first rule is parallel to the principal axis. Second rule is it has to pass through the optic center. After refraction, the parallel ray will be passing through the focal point. If you keep the object in between F and 2F, you will get an image beyond 2F. This is your condition. So you'll be having an image beyond F in a enlarged manner. So this is the condition, isn't it? So then I am going to draw in one more a big lens. This is called as eyepiece. This is called as eyepiece. It is kept nearer to the eye, so it is called as an eyepiece. So the image formed by the lens 1 act as an object. Image formed by the lens 1 or objective lens act as an object for the second lens. It will fall within the focus, within the focal point of your eye lens. So whenever an object is placed in between the optic center and focal point, what happens? As usual, the parallel ray and the ray which is passing through the center of optical center, the ray which is parallel after refraction will pass through the focus. That you know very well. Then the object is placed in front of the focal point, that is in between the optic center and focal points. So the image will be formed on the same side. The enlarged image will be formed on the same side. So extend these two lines. Extend these two lines where it will join. Where it will join. There you will get a very large image. Are you able to see this? The image formed by the first lens act as an object for your second lens, that is your eyepiece. Then that object, the image of your first lens act as an object. That object is placed in between the optic center and the focal point. So it will form a very large image on the same side. Here your eye. The lens which is kept near the eye, so it is called as eye lens. The lens which is kept in front of the object, so it is called as object lens. Are you able to understood the working of a compound microscope? I explained the working of a compound microscope. The compound microscope has 50 to 200 times more magnification power than simple microscope. The first one is simple microscope. The object is placed in between the optic center and focal point. Will forms an image on the same side. Enlarge, erect visual image. The same thing in the compound microscope. The compound microscope consists of two lens. One is object lens, another one is eye lens. The object placed in between F and 2F of a object lens forms an image beyond the 2F of the other side of your object lens. That image act as an object for your eye lens. So that image falls in between the optic center and focal point. So the same side enlarged image will be formed. This is the working of your compound microscope. There is one more microscope, that is traveling microscope. This is one of the best instrument for measuring very small length with a high degree of accuracy, 0.01 mm. Thank you. Have you understood this?